Hello guys, this is Asus K43SV laptop. The problem is that its input jack is problematic and its pins are removed. And as my customer says, there is no image. As you see, for connecting the jack, I can't solder it directly. So I connected wire to its input, so that I can turn on the device using wire and see why there is no image. I connect power supply to the wire. I connect its positive to input and connect the negative to either of the screw holes and turn on the device. As RTC battery is not on the laptop, laptop is going to turn on automatically when voltage enters it. You can see amperage draw as well. 1.27 is being drawn and it stays stable. The other thing I'd like to show is that this laptop gets stuck, hangs in one of the steps after turning on, and two LED lights stay on. As you know, they need to turn on, then turn off after some time. And eventually, only power LED needs to stay on. So, this means that the laptop has problems in booting. Let's see what the problem is. The first thing to do is checking ohm of board. I should check ohm of all inductors on the circuit. This one is 4 kilo ohm. The next one is 3 kilo ohm. They're probably for 3 and 5 volt always, which were normal ohm. This one is most probably RAM inductor. 247 ohm is proper for RAM. 22 to 23 ohm is most probably for chipsets. This inductor is most probably related to graphic, which is 6.2 ohm now. It's normal ohm for chip. This inductor is parallelized with the other one. Voltage most probably enters graphic chip from two phases. There is another inductor here, it's 4 mega ohm. It's also proper and normal. CPU inductors are under heat sink. They were 24 to 27 ohm. As you saw, the board is fine in terms of ohm. As this laptop turns on but there is no image, I need to check its RAM first. I'll change it with my test RAM and make sure to service RAM slot, as RAM or its slot might be problematic. That could cause laptop to face problems in booting. And as you saw, two LED lights stayed on. I'll service this RAM and also service the test RAM with dry electronic cleaner, so that if there is any problems on RAM slot, it would be solved by that. Let's turn on the laptop and see if LED light problem is fixed or not. As you see, the problem is still there, and it's not the RAM. Laptop is still hanging and doesn't boot up completely. Next step is to change CPU. and test it with another CPU, because CPU can be the problem. I'll remove and change it. I'll change the CPU with the test CPU. Let's see if it fixes the problem or not. No need to install heatsink as I want to test laptop for a couple of seconds. As you see, it's still not okay, so it's not the CPU either. CPU is heating up. This means that CPU voltages most probably entered it. Next step is to program BIOS. I'll install heatsink. Now I check voltages to see how they are. 5 volt and 3 volt are in here. No voltage drop. 1.5 volt of RAM is on this inductor, which is okay. Next voltage is graphic voltage. It's present as well. 1.05 volt is on this inductor. I can check board view to see which block it belongs to. This is most probably graphic inductor. 0.9 volt is present. 1.05 PCH voltage was present too, and I'm checking 1.1 voltage of CPU underscore core. So this board is normal in terms of voltage. There is no voltage drop. and 0.2 volt and 0.6 volt are present on two pins of crystal, which are okay. So I'll program BIOS. BIOS is programmed. Let's see if laptop problem gets fixed by that or not. As you see, I programmed BIOS, but the problem still remains.
و این دستگاه باز هم مشکل داره.